Good morning students. In the previous class we have seen some derivations on potential and absolute potential. That is, we have identified the expression for potential and absolute potential. Now we'll solve some numericals under the topic potential. Take down the first problem. Find the potential at point P -1, 2, 3 meter due to the point charge of -3 microcoulomb located at -3, 1, 1. So -3 is your test charge and it is located at the point -3, 1, 1, and this is the point where we need to identify the potential. So here also a cause and effect concept will come, where exactly we need to identify the parameter, that will be your effect point and the other point is your cause point. So we know that the potential V is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon into R. R is nothing but distance between your cause and effect. So when finding out your R, we should find it as effect distance minus cause distance. So after identifying, you will get the term, you will get a value called 3. Then substitute it. So V is equal to Q. Q is nothing but 3 microcoulomb. 3 microcoulomb means -3 microcoulomb. Micro means 10 to the power of minus 6. So -3 × 10⁻⁶ divided by 4 pi. Epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r. Epsilon naught is 8.854 × 10⁻¹². Epsilon r is not given, so you can write it as assume epsilon r is equal to 1, and in the place of r you have to substitute the magnitude of your distance vector. After identifying, you are getting one answer. The unit for the potential is volts. Now coming back to the next problem, two point charges -1 nanocoulomb and 1 nanocoulomb are located at point -3, 1, 5 meter and 6, -5, 2 meter respectively. Find the value of the electric scalar potential at point. So in the previous problem we have only one charge and one more is the point where we need to identify the potential. In this problem we have two point charges, that is -1 nanocoulomb and 1 nanocoulomb. Consider two point charges are placed at a point P and Q at -3, 1, 5 and 6, -5, 2. The charge available at point P and Q is -1 nanocoulomb and 1 nanocoulomb. We need to identify the electric scalar potential at point 3, -6, -9. So place the point 3, -6, -9. So here two cause and one effect. So this is the point where we need to identify the potential. So it is going to be your effect point. Rest all other points is going to be a cause. The distance from point 1 to the effect point is R1 and the distance from point 2 to the effect point is R2. Now the total potential at this point will be equal to VR1, that is potential due to point P plus potential due to point Q. So VR1 is the potential due to point P, which can be written as QP, what is the charge available, divided by 4 pi epsilon and what is its distance. In case if you want to identify the potential at R point due to point charge Q, so we can write it as VR2, which is equal to QQ, that is what is the charge available at this particular point, divided by 4 pi epsilon and this particular distance, magnitude of your distance. Identify the magnitude of the distance R1. So VR1 is equal to QP divided by 4 pi epsilon, and we know that epsilon is 8.854 × 10⁻¹², and here epsilon R is equal to 1 into the distance vector. After identifying, you are getting 1 volt. Same thing, VR2 is equal to QQ divided by 4 pi epsilon into R2. So we know that the charge available at point Q is -1 nanocoulomb. So nano means 10⁻⁹ divided by 4 pi epsilon multiplied by the distance vector. It is your VR2. And the electric scalar potential, the total potential at this particular point is the summation of potential occurred due to point P as well as point Q. So we can write it as electric scalar potential at point R is equal to VR is equal to VR1 plus VR2. What is your VR1 here you have identified, that is -0.536 volt, and what is your VR2? 0.7857. So when you add those two values of the potential, you will get the net potential at point R. So we are getting VR is equal to 0.2497. What is the unit for potential? It is old. Coming back to the next problem, the next problem is a point charge of 6 nanocoulomb is located at the origin in free space. Find potential at point P if it is located at point 0.2 comma minus 0.4 comma 0.4. So they had given some conditions. V is equal to 0 at infinity. Like suppose if you are moving a charge from infinity to the point under consideration, then it is going to be your absolute potential. And one more point is also given. V is equal to 0 at 1, 0, 0. And V is equal to 20 at minus 0.5, 1, minus 1 meter. Here the charge to be moved is 6 nanocoulomb. This is located at the origin. We need to identify the potential at point P. If it is located at the point 0.2, -0.4, 4 meter. Now just draw the convert the problem into your pictorial representation. You have one charge which is placed at 0, 0, 0, and you need to identify the potential at point 0.2, -0.4, 0.4 meter. Now three cases they had given. In the first case, your potential is 0 at infinity. So case 1, you write it. Vp, normally the potential formula is q divided by 4 pi epsilon into r. So we can write r is nothing but your distance vector. Distance vector is nothing but the distance between your cause and effect. So what is, which is your cause and which is your effect here? It is the point we need to identify your potential. So this is going to be your effect and it is going to be your cause. To identify the distance vector r, you need to do it effect distance minus cause distance. Likewise, if you do it, you are going to get the magnitude of the distance vector as 0.6 meter. Now potential at point P, Vp is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon into R. R already you have identified, and the value of Q given is 6 nanocoulomb. So 6 nano means 6 into 10 to the power of minus 9 divided by 4 pi epsilon, this epsilon not into epsilon R. Since epsilon R is not given, you can write epsilon R is equal to 1 and epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12 into distance vector is 0.6. After identifying, you are getting Vp is equal to 90 volt. Now what is your case 2? Case 2 is V is equal to 0 at 1, 0, 0. Now here there is a new point called 1, 0, 0. At this particular point, your potential is going to be 0. But here the potential is not going to be 0. Now identify the distance. It is your initial value and this is your final value. So the potential at this particular point is going to be 0. Now identify the initial distance vector. Identifying, you will get 1. So when you are moving a unit charge from point A to point B, the potential difference is Q divided by 4 pi epsilon, 1 divided by RF minus 1 divided by RI. We know what is your RF distance. RF is nothing but from point P to origin. RF, RI is nothing but point A to origin. Substitute and identify the voltage parameter. So in this condition we are getting approximately 36 volt. But what is the potential at point A? Because at this point the potential will be summation of the potential available due to this point and summation of the potential available due to this point. So at this particular point the potential is 0. So when we then you have to identify the net potential. Vp is equal to Vap plus Va. Vap is nothing but voltage vector between the point A to P, that is 36, plus Va is 0, so 36 volt. Now what is your case 3? In a given problem, case 3 is V is equal to 20 volt at 0, -0.5, 1, -1. So here we can write it as case 3. You have one point at origin, this is your normal point, and one more point at B you have. So here V is equal to 20 at this particular point. Now identify the initial distance vector. After identifying, you are getting 1.5 meter. So when you are moving a point charge from point B to point P, then the formula is Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 1 by RF minus 1 by RI. Here RF value is distance between O to P, RI is distance between O to B. After substituting, you are getting 54, but it is the voltage vector between the point B to P. But already condition is given, V is equal to 20 at -0.5, 1, -1. Therefore, the total potential will be summation of VBP plus VP. So we will get 74.